From the Opelka Studios in Oklahoma City, this is an OU update. I'm Jenni Carlson. There are lots of Sooners in Indianapolis this week for the NFL Combine. Travis Haney joins us on the phone right now to talk a little bit about some of these guys. And Travis, even though there are a lot of Sooners participating, probably going to get drafted by NFL teams, is there a for sure first round guy, or are most of these guys going to be after the first round this year?
Yeah, I don't think we're talking about this year being the case for the Sooner. That, you know, if Landry Jones had come out, maybe it would be a different story, and we'd probably have a different focus for OU. But, no, I don't think this is a big-time first-round kind of class. We talked some about Ronnell Lewis. He could sneak maybe into the end of the first round, depending on how he does this weekend in Indianapolis. But, no, I think we're looking at more guys falling in the second, third, fourth round, those kinds of players. OU does have seven players in Indianapolis. I think that's the most of any Big 12 team. One guy is sort of a curious case is Ryan Broyles, who's there, not participating in the workouts, obviously, because of his knee injury. But we'll go through some of the interviews, talk to some of the teams. I know he started running. He's not going to run there. There's no reason for that. But the fact that he's working his way back into shape after that November 5th injury, I think that'll impress a lot of teams. And you know Ryan, you've been around Ryan. He's a very charismatic guy, very good guy, so he'll fare well in the interviews. I'm sure he'll help himself there. He's not going to do anything to hurt himself in terms of what's happened with the injury. He can demonstrate to teams that he's back on the right track. So I think he's a guy who could, if anything, and it sounds strange, improve his stock this weekend just by being there and speaking with teams. Additionally, I think Jamel Fleming is a player to watch just because he did so well in the Senior Bowl lead-up and the practices and those types of things to catch scouts' eyes. He played physically in his senior year, just a really impressive season, the kind of build and player that they like in the NFL at cornerback. So those are two players maybe to watch early in the draft, not first-round kind of guys, but maybe second day.
You mentioned Ronnell Lewis earlier, guy that's probably got the most to prove or the most to gain this week, might, as you say, really solidify his spot as a late first-round guy. But are there other Sooners that you feel like could really see a swing in where their draft stock lies depending on how they perform this weekend?
Well, I think Frank Alexander might be another interesting one to watch just because we saw what sort of season Frank could have, and he's obviously very physically gifted. He's a big guy, runs well, gets to the quarterback well, tackles well. So, I mean, he does all the things that you've seen out of Sooners who have gone to play in the NFL, linemen who have gone to play in the NFL. I like him. I like the way that he played his senior season. So I'm kind of thinking he could fly under the radar in terms of some of the defensive end prospects that are out there. I know they're talking a lot about the kid Copels from North Carolina and players like that being early first-round picks. Frank's not anything like that. But in the middle rounds, I really feel like a team could get a steal in Frank Alexander.
All right. Thanks, Travis. Be sure to stay with the best coverage team anywhere at newsok.com and every day in the Oklahoman. All right, good.